bought this machine 5 years ago and have installed it at the same time also a DRO and engaging the DRO at the X and the AS. I had some problems with the original DRO displays. Here I have two of them. There are used mini USB connectors inside here and also inside the thing here. And the housing itself is also a mini USB connector. These connectors are not very, very good because they come loose and you have lost your position and you don't know where the correct position is. So I have removed this. I have bought some additional things, measurement things. One for the column here, I have already installed, and one for this one here. This must be replaced also by another one. But the main disadvantage of these displays is the readability, because here it is often, it is very difficult to see it. And also this one also, it's an A display. You cannot, as you see, the display is very, it is sometimes hard to see because of the reflection and so on. Also this one here is completely in the dark, so it is quite impossible to see it for the grill here. So I have decided to install for this and these two and the other one on the column to install a touch DRO. The touch DRO, the first version is this version that I make it with a board from Yuri, the designer of it, and a power supply, 2 watt power supply for this board here. But this one was not very well and not good, because the display was not stable. There's on certain axis on the machine, it was not stable. It was stable in the lab, but not on the machine. So I go then for another solution to try further with the engaging TRO, and that's with an Arduino. And I have installed that on the machine now. This one was the first one, and because it was jumping on the X or the A as some figures that I was losing the exact measurement, I decided to give a try to the Arduino and to take care of the installation more. Now I have the installation done here. That is this box with these lights here. So we have a light of the Arduino and a blinking light of the Bluetooth connection on the Bluetooth module. And the two other lights are to control the power supplies. I designed a special board to fit everything nicely. So I have also add pull-up resistors, because that's important, because the serial communication, the first bit is always a zero. Yes, and if there are, if you have a floating thing or nothing, that means that you have no connection. So there's always a one is good for the electronics. As display I use a Galaxy tab, the cheapest one, €110 I think. And it is connected now with a Bluetooth module. So there is another blinking now. It's much slower. That means connected. So this device is built with the standard USB connectors, because with the mini and the micro USB you have always some bad contact, and it gives always a flickering result on the screen. So I decided to use the standard USB, and it is sometimes soldered in the sense box of the DRO. So now I have make a setup to check the linearity of this rule here, because it is not a glass scale, and I want to know how precise the rule it is. So I have set here a comparator and set it on 0, and here I must also set on 0 on the thing here. So everything is set on 0. It is a 1-2-3 block that I has fixed it square to the table movement, and I want to use gauge blocks to measure and to calibrate the instruments here. The calibration is already done, but I want to check if I put 200 millimeter inside here, that it is 200 millimeter. So I want to notize everything. Dus first we start with a gauge block of 50 millimeter. So I make room for it. Dus I insert now the gauge block of 50 millimeter, and I set the comparator on 0. This is on 0. This measurement is also on 0 on the comparator, and the reading is 50.01. So I do it for several points. I will repeat it for let's say it's 100 millimeters and so on. So I will take several steps, and then I will make some conclusions how far it is off. But all these steps, because it is a 50, I can have a tafel movement of 50 millimeters. It takes a long time to set all the stack of the gauge blocks here. But you must measure with the gauge block, otherwise you are wrong. So what I can sell from e-gauging, I have also bought a caliper, AZ-Cal, from e-gauging. It is also made in China, but these cost €30, but they are very good. So if you, so I have 0 now, and if I test with the gauge block, you are always right here. I have a gauge block of 40 millimeter now. Kijk, dat is always correct. Dus I will continue off camera for the next measurements. Hello, I want to jump to some conclusions. We have here the distance of the hose blocks, the length of the hose blocks, and here we have the figures on the display. You see, this is the delta in micron. You see, there's a slight difference above longer distances. So the Eco-Zing rules are not linear, but with this error I can live with. So in the lower range it is okay, but at a higher range it takes more deltas. So let me check about the prices. I have made the boat units, not from Yuri and not from Arduino. So here we have some customs from Belgium. If you ordered something to the US, you have to pay this amount here, 50 euros. So there's a lot of money for a part who has that cost. So the whole build from the little board from Yuri is a little less than 200 euros. So I did it the same thing with Arduino. I bought modules on Amazon and also the Bluetooth module also on Amazon. And these parts are locals, part that you can find it in an electronic shop. So, and this cost me 74 euros, 50% less than, at least 50% less than the Yuri thing. But yeah, I'm happy with this. It works very well now. All noise problems that I have with the display are solved. It works good and I'm happy. So for the guys who live in Europe, it is better to choose to make a choice of the Arduino. For the US people, maybe you don't pay that amount of shipping and the Belgium cost. It's better to stay with the Yuri thing here. So regarding the whole system setup, it is good for me. So meanwhile, through the using of a Galaxy tab, I have at a workshop also a calculator, and that was also a needed thing, an interesting thing to have it in the close to the machine. I thank you for watching, and I hope you to see you later back on the other videos. Some videos will be planned in a few weeks and a few months. Now I have already some ideas for 3 new videos, and for this year also, certainly, and I see what is coming. So keep safe and keep your healthy, and say you goodbye.